YouTube, this is Sweet Jazz, and I just wanted to do like a small vlog today. I'm gonna put up some pictures and throughout the video, excuse me, because I wanted to talk about you know, everything I've been through in the last, my daughter's gonna be 6 months, so from the time I was 6 months pregnant till now, I would say. A lot has happened, a lot of changes. I was working when I found out that I was pregnant. We had been trying for a while and it didn't work out. And then when I got a job, I found out I was pregnant. So during my pregnancy, around 6 months, I developed gestational diabetes. And they put me on a really strict diet. I had to take my blood 4 times a day and call it in. I had to go to the hospital once a week. This made me very concerned. So I decided, you know, I need to take care of my baby. I don't want her to get hurt. I don't want anything to happen to her. And, you know, if you have gestational diabetes, what happens is your child, they tend to grow quicker. And there can be complications with her health because of it. Also, the baby can be born, you have high blood sugar, so your baby can be born with low blood sugar, which might mean that they might have to keep her. All these different things that I did not want to deal with. She's in the living room watching cartoons. That's just her talking. So I decided, you know, I have to buckle down. I have to do what they say. The diet was I couldn't have sweets, which is like my thing. I love candy. I love all that stuff. I couldn't have any soda, no juice. I was only allowed water. So from 6 months to 9 months till I had her. That first month killed me. That first month was so hard. And my husband and my kids, they love like their brownies and their cakes. And he would bake for them. And, you know, he wasn't doing it to be mean. He's a great dad. But, oh, it killed me when I would smell the brownies. But I had to do it because I needed my baby to be healthy. Long story short, I did it for the few months that I was pregnant. And after I had her, when they took her out, I realized before I got pregnant, I was 204 pounds. I was heavy. I don't know how many of you have followed any of my earlier videos, but if you see it in my face, I've lost since then. I'm now down to 164, which is still not where I should be, but from 204 to 164, it's about 35, 40 pounds almost. And I feel great. And like, I'm feeling great about the weight loss. This has sparked a whole new lifestyle for me now. I no longer drink soda and juice. I stick to water, and I actually prefer it now, which is weird because anyone who knows me knew that that wasn't going to happen. I had to have my soda. And, you know, every now and then I'll have a sip if we're out or something. Even when we're out, most of the time I'll order a couple of ice water. And the servers will look at me like I'm crazy. I don't know why, but they do. So now it's got me wanting to continue feeling good about myself. I mean, I walk now to go pick up my kids, and just today I walked to the store. It's not too close to my house, but, you know, maybe a good 15-minute walk, and I wasn't even tired when I came home, which is crazy to me. Because a year ago, I couldn't walk to my kids' school, which is only a 10-minute walk, 5-minute walk, without being out of breath, without being in pain. And now I'm walking, you know, I'm able to do things. Me and my sister-in-law just started doing the Zumba workouts. Oh my gosh, those workouts are crazy. But they're really fun, and, you know, you are tired afterwards, but I find myself being able to do it. Where, you know, before I wouldn't have, please, after like 10 minutes, I would have been like, shut it off and turn the TV on. My family, my kids are starting, we eat mostly the 100 calorie packs now, and we're trying to cut back. You know, I can't make them eat the way I'm eating just because I want to lose weight. I do want them healthier, but I have to, you know, slowly put them into it. My husband's trying as well. They like their sweets though. But it's been awesome. I mean, I can't even believe that I have this new body, and I feel so good. And I don't ever want to go back to that. I don't ever want to go back to where I was. It's so important to me. And I thank God, because honestly, I prayed a lot. And I told God, if you just give me a head start and let me lose some of this weight, I'll keep it off. And He did. It wasn't me. I don't even know how those months went by so fast. I don't even know how I lost the 30 pounds. I know I followed, you know, what they told me, but it had to be God. you know, taking that weight off like that. 30 pounds? What? Like, I'm still baffled. And after I had her, I was down to 174. And that blew me away. And for me to be down to 164 now, I'm like, wow. That's just God. It really is. And I'm so grateful. And I'm trying to keep my end and keep on, you know, not adding bad things to the diet. And, you know, I'm not dieting. I'm not sitting here saying that I don't eat. I like to eat, you know. But I'm, you know, trying to stay away from the sweets. And I'm trying to stay away from overeating. And I'm continuing with the water. And I'm getting the exercise. And I'm not at my goal. You know, I don't want to be super skinny. My husband doesn't like it when you're too small. So I still want to lose a good 20 pounds. And after that, I'll be happy. I don't want to be a stick. I don't want to be super tiny. I, you know, want to tone some things up, get rid of the belly. But I don't want to be, like, sick looking. So, to me, if I'm too skinny, my face is going to look crazy. It's already now, once I lost the weight, I can see these lines, like, these smile lines. And in my forehead. And it's just because the skin is so loose now. It's, like, crazy. I know that looks crazy right now, but it's true. Before, my face was much more full. And now I'm getting all these little lines and stuff that are driving me nuts. But it's worth it. I don't know what else I can say. That's been what I've been through. That process was really not easy, being pregnant, not being able to eat whatever you want. But it was so worth it. She's healthy. She came out. She was my smallest baby. Go figure. All of my kids were over 8 pounds. And my oldest was 9'4". Maya was only 7'15". She was so tiny, 7'15", and I thank God for allowing me to stick through it and get it done, and now she's here, and she's a blessing, and I know I've talked a lot through this video, but I just wanted to tell everybody what was going on, and I'm going to do a haul video and some other videos probably later today. I've been staying home since I had Maya. I haven't gone back to work because I feel like she's my last one, and I don't want to miss anything. And I don't really want to just leave her with everyone. The other thing I am doing is I'm also breastfeeding. And I've heard that helps you lose weight with, you know, a good diet and exercise. And let me tell you, it's true. Because it's been working for me. And it's the best bonding experience in the world. And there she goes. So thank you for listening, YouTube. Sorry I'm rambling so much, but I really appreciate everyone who has subscribed recently. I appreciate all of your views and your comments. Have a blessed day. Listen up, let me tell everybody about my God who reigns. Can't boast just a little bit about his holy name. He controls the whole universe, but cares enough to fill my cup. So shout to the Lord, sing along with me, and lift the praises up. You say yeah.